bring it here, bring it here.
I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna do it.
The president is this way.
أخي بعد الناس من هنا أخي. Just to remind.
Adam,
hold this. Yes, come around. Come around. The most beneficent. I want to share beautiful chapter from the Quran with you, brothers and sisters, and ladies and gentlemen. This is a powerful chapter. Tell us about the reality of this life. All of us, we are busy with our life, but we're forgetting that the life that we are so busy with it, one day we have to leave it. One day we have to leave it. Allah sent the Quran, Al-Hakum Takathur, that these worldly affairs, this life occupied you, made you very busy. Al-Hakum Takathur, Hatta Zurtum Al-Maqabir, until you will visit the graves. When you speak about the death, many people are scared of it, but nothing is guaranteed in this life except death. We're not ready for death, but death is ready for us. How many people left their houses, they never come back? How many people went to sleep, they never wake up? So the death that we try to run away from surely will meet us, and we will return to our Creator. Our purpose for this life, or our purpose of this life, not just to waste time and enjoyment, rather we have been created for a greater purpose. That's why in the Quran, Allah always remind the people with something which is so powerful, the death. Allah said, say to them, the death that you try to run away from surely will meet you, and you will return to your Lord. We are in this life for a greater purpose, to worship the Creator. If our eyes has a purpose, our kidney has a purpose, our heart has a purpose, what about us as a whole? What is our purpose for life in this life? Do we ask this question to ourselves? When we're here, when we have to die, when we're going to go after the death, or we are too busy playing games, or we are too busy going to nightclubs, or we are too busy paying bills? Bear in mind, when you die, nothing will come of you. When they put you inside the grave, nothing will come of you except your actions. So we have to ask ourselves, as a human being, with a sound reasoning and a natural inclination, why we have been created? What is our purpose in this life? Of course, when you reflect upon the creation, you can see clearly that this creation has been created for reason, and there is a wisdom behind it. So this chapter in the Quran, which is a powerful chapter, remind mankind the purpose for this life. Allah mentioned, you are too busy with this life until you will visit the graves. Mean until you die. Al-Hakum al-Takathur, Hatta Zurtum al-Maqabir, Kalla Sawfa Ta'alamun, Thumma Kalla Sawfa Ta'alamun. You will know, surely you will come to know. Kalla Law Ta'alamun Ilma Al-Yaqeen. If you only knew with certainty, لَتَرَوُنَّ الْجَحِيمِ. You will see the hellfire. So all brothers and sisters, ladies and gentlemen, we are, as I have mentioned, when you reflect upon this creation, there is a wisdom behind our creation. So therefore, logic dictates, the only one knows about our creation and our purpose, he's the one who created us, the one who made us. Let us ask this question to ourselves. Why we have to die? What will happen to us after we're going to die? When we're here, the answer, the Most High, the Most Merciful, has given it to us through His prophets and His messengers. God give us intellect, not to be like animals, just eat and drink and sleep. Rather, give us intellect to utilize it and to come to know that we have a purpose for this life. So what is our purpose? Is it our purpose to sleep all day? Is our purpose to keep drinking night and day. It's our purpose to smoke drugs. What is our purpose? Is to be grateful and to worship our Creator. To learn and to worship your Creator. I always give this example. If I give you £2 million as a gift, what would you say to me? You would say thank you without any time, without any doubt. But if I give you £2 million on a condition, give me your two eyes, you will not do that, because your eyes is more valuable than £2 million. So why don't you be grateful to the one who gave you eyes for free? Why don't you be grateful to the one who gave you life for free? If someone come try to kill us, we would do anything to save our life, because our life is so dear to us, is so beloved to us. So why we are not grateful to the one who gave us this life for free? So brothers and sisters, ladies and gentlemen, as I have mentioned, when you reflect and you see there is a wisdom behind this creation, logic dictates, the one who will tell us about our creation, our purpose, is the Creator. To make it clearer, if I make a phone from scratch, no one knows about the phone better than I, because I made it. Likewise, no one knows what is good and bad in detail for his creation except the Creator, without any doubt, except the Creator. That's why, based upon his wisdom and his mercy and his justice, he sent prophets and messengers to teach us about our purpose for this life. Like Moses, Jesus, Abraham, Jacob, Isaac, Jeremiah, Daniel, and other prophets and messengers. And the last of them is the Prophet Muhammad. Because as I have mentioned, logically speaking, yes, we should be grateful to our Creator. But the second question, if you want to buy a gift for your mother, would you buy a gift that you love or your mother love? Of course, you want to buy a gift your mother love. Likewise, if you want to be grateful and you want to worship your Creator, you should worship him the way he loves, because it's objective. As for the way we love, it's subjective. Now, again, as I have mentioned, God sent the prophets and messengers. But there are some people claim to be prophets and messengers, but they are liars. They're not true prophets and messengers. So how can we differentiate between true prophets and the false prophets? The true prophets and messengers are known amongst the nations to be truthful and honest, like Jesus, Moses, Abraham, Prophet Muhammad. Likewise, they come with a prophecy. Let me share with you, my brothers and sisters, ladies and gentlemen, some prophecies that Prophet Muhammad mentioned, and reflect upon it. Prophet Muhammad said, who lived 1,400 years ago in the middle of desert in Mecca, he said, there will come a time when you see the barefoot Arab man competing in building tall buildings. And we know now the tallest building in the world is in Dubai. Again, the question you ask yourself, how do we know that? Another one, Prophet Muhammad said, will come a time when the Arabs, they will stop using camels as a riding beast, and they will use something as a box that will carry them from their houses to the mosque. If you go Qatar, Kuwait, Saudi, Dubai, they don't use the camels like before, but they use the cars. Again, how a man that lived 1,400 years ago knew about something is happening right now. We can observe it. You don't have to be Muslim to observe it, or a Christian. Everyone can observe it. So the question you ask yourself, how do you know that? Another one, in the Quran, Allah mentioned, وَلَقَدْ يَسَّنَّا الْقُرْآنَ لِلذِّكْرِ فَهَلْ مِنْ مُدَّكِرٍ. We have made the Quran easy to be memorized. We know there is 100 million of people memorize the Quran word by word, letter by letter. Allah mentioned that 1,400 years ago. How he knew that? Of course, Allah is the creator of everything. He knows the past and he will know the future. So the question you ask yourself, brothers and sisters, ladies and gentlemen, of course, there's many temptation around us. There is a fanfare over there. There's a nice club on the other side. You just want to enjoy your life. But remember, you have not been created for this purpose. You have been created for a greater purpose. Think about it. You're not the first person to die. You're going to die. You'll not be the last person. Think about the grave. Why we have to die? Ask ourselves. When the death comes to you, no one can save you. As Allah said, لَقَدْ جِئْتُمُونَ فُرَادًا. You return to us just as we have created you. Allah said, O Muhammad, say to them, the death that you try to run away from surely will meet you. We will do anything to save ourselves from death. But when the death comes to you, doesn't care who you are, king or a queen or a policeman or a highway robber. When the angel death comes to you, we'll take your soul, regardless how much money you have. When they put you inside the grave, doesn't matter who you are, you'll be questioned about this life. And you'll be questioned on the day of resurrection. This is just a reminder to me first and to you. May Allah bless you and may Allah guide you for you to reflect upon it. Because I understand, I was like that before, but I'm too busy doing this, doing that. Forget about God, forget about death. But guess what? Nothing is guaranteed in this life except death. So as a human, with a sound reasoning, let me step back. Well, I'm like a sheep following everyone. Step back. Well, I'm here. Why do I have to die? What is my purpose? Ask this question to yourself. And if you have any question or correction, no problem. I'm not perfect. I'm a human being. I make mistakes. So I will open the platform for people to ask or to correct me. Do you have water? I was not there to see him. I was not with Adam to see how tall he was, you know. I was not there with Adam. Anyway, we'll stop here, inshallah.